Everyone needs food to survive. But have you ever wondered where it comes from and the costs to the people who grow and produce it? You may be aware of the importance of environmental sustainability, but what about the importance of social sustainability? There are millions of people we rarely think about that work in the fields and plants every day to bring us the food we eat. This is Lucina Ibarra Diaz, a farm worker and mother of three. She is one of those people. Despite its importance to all of us, producing our food is one of the lowest paying and most dangerous jobs in the world. Many farm workers live in extreme poverty, face harsh working conditions, and a rare few have access to basic benefits like health care and education. Many families can't afford a home of their own and live in crowded and unsafe apartments or housing units. Farm workers also have some of the highest rates of chemical poisoning due to the exposure to pesticides and fertilizers. What if we could change this? What if the...
Okay. Thank you very much for the invitation. Thank you for the university. Thank you, Dr. Gomez. I want to share with you some ideas, some projects are working in Mexico. We are in the center of Mexico, and they are working very nice. We are very proud about this. We divide this presentation in three sections. How to alleviate the poverty, who we are, and the next steps. This company was founded by my father and my mother. My father was a very entrepreneurial guy. He started in the high school to travel around the country in the bicycle, around through the rivers in this folded kayak, and start a company without money, and start flying at 50 years old. All the time start with the new entrepreneurs. Okay, we are taking this idea from CK. It's a very, well, trying to make the democratic commerce. We are making these projects from 57, and this is education, joint venture, and entrepreneurial development. We will start with the education. We have a project with scholarships for the kids. We found the kids start two or three grades, the fathers, and when they stay in the school, they stay for sixth grade, and the first father says, it's okay, let's go. Come the next one, or it's enough. And now, with this system, they stay in the school, to high school, and some university, all the way to the, they can go to the master. We have some, about 10% of the employees of this, of our system, are coming from this project. All of this green, market with green, they are coming with this project. I asked Carlos to share with us his experience. He started like a taxi driver, and now is the director of production in the plant. He leads 1,200 people, and he is a very respected people in the community.
Soy Carlos Gutiérrez, actualmente tengo el puesto de director de manufactura. Estuve anteriormente a la huerta trabajando en tiempo parcial como chofer de taxi. Sí, yo tuve la oportunidad de empezar a trabajar aquí siendo un estudiante en la carrera durante mi ingeniería. Durante un año y medio prácticamente tuve oportunidad de estar haciéndolo en jornada reducida, donde sabía que era un estudiante que trabajaba y no un trabajador que estudiaba, enfocándome fuertemente en ese momento en mi educación profesional. Yo tengo ya prácticamente 2 décadas trabajando en la compañía. He pasado por diferentes áreas y he tenido diferentes responsabilidades. Inicialmente estuve trabajando como analista en laboratorio, también después en el área de almacén, un tiempo después en saneamiento de planta, un poco después en el área de control de calidad. Finalmente empecé a moverme ya en el área de manufactura, como jefe de producción entonces, después como gerente de planta y recientemente ya como la dirección. Y pues bueno, la compañía es una fábrica de oportunidades, yo siempre lo he visto así. La compañía ha evolucionado, crece vertiginosamente y siempre ha habido áreas en las que uno puede colaborar. Estoy muy orgulloso de mi familia principalmente y ellos posteriormente también ven la compañía como una empresa ejemplar en la que también ellos visualizan en algún momento poder trabajar en una empresa así o tal vez en esta misma, dependiendo de lo que ellos deseen.
Okay, I'm very proud about this project. Carlos, in January, asked my wife and me to visit his house. They construct his house by itself. And I was very surprised. The house is much better and bigger than my house. And like him, it's a lot of people. Yeah? The second project is to try to grow with the growers around the farm. We have to grow them with us. We want to grow with us, and we invest in all of these issues, technical, financial, and some. We have a team teaching them how to harvest, and now the results are very, very surprised. They made 50% of our products in this system. It's close to 50 million pounds a year on different vegetables. But it's with better quality and better yields than us. It's working by itself, and they are growing. I asked Candelario to share with us his experience. He started like a farmer for self-consumption, and now he has his sons working with him, and it's a bigger farm with 140 acres. He started with mules, and now he has a tractor, and it's working very nice. It's his history.
Por allá en 1985 yo me acerqué con el señor Jorge, con el motivo de que me compraba unas zanahorias. Y arreglamos, me las compró. Cuando ya acabé de arreglar aquello, le pedí planta al señor Jorge. El señor Jorge me escuchó. Y de aquel tiempo a estas fechas, seguimos trabajando con ellos, con el rancho, medio kilo. Ahorita quienes trabajan y mueven los trabajos son mis hijos.
Mi nombre es Mario Espino Flores. En aquel tiempo mi papá trabajaba 10 hectáreas de maíz, frijol para el autoconsumo. Ahorita en la actualidad trabajamos 70 hectáreas. Ahorita trabajamos con riego por goteo. Cuando teníamos 10 hectáreas trabajábamos riego corrido. Trabajábamos con mulas y nada más trabajaban 8 personas. Bueno, ahorita tenemos 60 trabajadores que representan 60 familias. Sería un promedio más o menos de 300 personas las que se están manteniendo del rancho que estamos trabajando, la familia Espino. En el 2010 estuvimos más o menos cosechando 1,000 toneladas de brócoli. Estamos trabajando muy a gusto con la huerta, porque la huerta nos ha apoyado para comprar tractores, nos ha financiado y nos ha cobrado unos intereses muy bajos.
This is our family philosophy and our business model. The third presentation is about the other side of the company. This is providing the raw material, and the other side is providing packing materials or products already finished, like strawberries or ice pops or peppers or chile relleno. And he's working with a third generation and some other suppliers. We are teaching them how to improve the products, how we have better products. And now they are our packing suppliers. This one is Manuel. He's our packing supplier. And it has products very nice. Now they are supplying another big companies like milk and foods. He started like a gardener with my father, and now he has a big plant with many employees.
En el 1970 inicié plantando brócoli en el rancho medio kilo y en el asadón. Un día el ingeniero José Arteaga me invita a su casa a trabajar de jardinero. Cuando yo los sábados o los fines de semana que andaba trabajando con él de jardinero, pues yo le pedía consejos entre bromas que se hacía de cómo superarse en la vida, que es muy difícil. Y pues me decía en bromas, riéndose, pues que el dueño siempre era el primero que tenía que llegar al trabajo y el último en retirarse, que si quería tener un éxito en la vida, tanto en el negocio como en el trabajo, tenía que ser uno trabajador, puntual y muy chambeador y muy con mucha honestidad. Y bueno, pues los consejos a seguir han sido esos. Después de 7 años me retiro y empiezo a trabajar vendiendo, comercializando y recordando las palabras que él me decía 25 años atrás. Después de que estuve con ellos, regreso a ofrecerles empaque para sus productos, lo cual me lo aceptan, pero con ciertas exigencias. Y bueno, pues gracias a la exigencia de la huerta y el apoyo que nos dan, pues hemos entrado con otras empresas fuertes, lo cual que nosotros nos hemos apoyado con maquinaria de tecnología americana, brasileña, alemana, tanto maquinaria como materias primas. Pues ahí tenemos 65 trabajadores, que la mayoría están casados, y pues viendo así las cosas, son 65 familias que vivimos de la empresa.
Okay. And we are looking for sustainable business for the community. Now, with all of these systems, we win some bids with big companies like Costco and Walmart and other companies. And not only for the quality or price, we win because all of these systems, ecologist and sustainable for social. And with these systems, we win a big contracts with them. More distribution centers we are supplying. Our vision in the beginning was focused on products, and now it's oriented to global competitive supply chain. And we are looking at talent, agriculture, industrial, and logistics. We are in these countries around the world and growing little by little. This is our brands, the main brands. This is a brand co-branding with Kirkland. And this is for the base of the pyramid brand. It's the same quality, but with a cheaper product. Probably in the blends has more carrots or something cheaper, no? But the quality is the same. We are working with this private labels and some alliance with Tyson and Schwann's. We are distributing their products in Mexico. We're very proud about these trophies. We were the supplier of the year in these years with Safeway, Walmart, and Nestle. This is another program. We are working ecological with compost and big projects for make biogas, water preservation, and the social, we have health programs, and we have sport programs to reduce the vandalism, and the education cafeteria and daycare for the kids. We have 70% of our employees are women, and we put this daycare. What's next? We are migrating from the commodity products to healthy solution around the lifestyle. We are using new technologies and with greenhouses. We have a biological control. We supply for Nestle 100% of the spinach with no pesticides, no fungicides, no pesticides. It's absolutely clean. We supply for Trader Joe's products with no pesticides, and others for organics for Costco. We are working the transition to the next generation. We are preparing the company for the grow. And around the five P's, this is our family philosophy, our business model, and our commitment for the business owners. Thank you.